Hi. In this module, we're going to discuss another very important concept on the USG firewall, which is called server load balancing. Server load balancing is a general feature which is available in most of the data center environments, and server load balancing is also available on the USG firewall. What happens is that whenever there are multiple servers providing the same service in a data center or in a server environment, the load needs to be distributed across those servers so that whenever a request comes for that service or for that particular application, that request has to be sent to one of the multiple servers which are providing the same service. In order to do this, you need a device which is capable of understanding the different servers which are providing the same service in the form of a cluster, and then distribute different requests coming in to each of those servers one by one depending upon the load balancing algorithm that we are using in this environment. This feature or this concept is called server load balancing, or SLB, in which different servers are sharing the user requests or sharing the load that is coming in from the users, and they are being managed by a device which is doing the SLB or server load balancing. And in our case, the server load balancing is being done by the firewall. The objectives of this module are very simple, that we are going to look at the basic principles and concepts of server load balancing technology, and then we'll be looking at the deployment and the configuration of load balancing on the firewall. The contents include the basic overview of SLB, then the different scenarios in which SLB can be implemented, and finally the configuration and deployment of server load balancing, or SLB. This slide explains what we just discussed briefly, that if you have different physical servers which are all providing the same service, either these three servers or these three servers, if they are providing the same service, then we need to make sure that any request that is coming in from the users for the services or the service that is running on these servers, we need to make sure that the traffic coming in is being sent or is being shared by all these servers. And this firewall, which is sitting in between at the egress of the network, is responsible for distributing the traffic coming in to these servers. And that traffic is distributed across all of these servers so that all the traffic does not go to a single server and it is distributed across these servers. In this case, there are different concepts, so there are certain terms that you need to understand. This is the scenario of server load balancing, where these servers are being load balanced by the firewall, or the firewall is load balancing the traffic across these servers, these physical servers. So these servers are called physical servers or the real servers. They form a group or a cluster, and we call this a real server group or a real server cluster, which means that they are part of a cluster or part of a group across which we want to do load balancing or across which we want to implement server load balancing. Then we have a logical server or a virtual server. The purpose of this server, obviously it's a virtual server. This means that this server does not exist physically. This is just a logical server which is representing these physical servers to the end users. So the end users are actually sending traffic to this logical server, to the IP address or the port number and the port number of this logical server. And the firewall intercepts these requests which are trying to reach this logical server and distributes these requests across these physical servers and distributes a load across them. That is why we call it server load balancing. So the logical server is the server for which the requests are being sent by the users. And this logical server is actually representing these physical servers at the back. The next concept is that how does the firewall make sure that the requests are distributed across these servers, or what algorithm will the firewall use, or the SLB feature within the firewall will use, what load balancing algorithm will the SLB use, SLB feature use, to distribute the load across these servers. That is determined by the load balancing algorithm that we are using on the firewall for distributing the traffic across these servers. So the SLB feature on this firewall is going to use a load distribution algorithm or load balancing algorithm, which is going to make sure that the traffic is sent to these physical servers in an orderly manner. And then finally, we have another concept called the health check, so that the firewall or the load balancing for the SLB feature running on the firewall is capable of knowing if one of the physical servers goes down, so that it does not keep sending traffic to that physical server, and it stops sending the traffic to that server and starts sending the traffic to the other servers, or keeps sending the traffic to the other servers and stops sending to the server which has gone down or which is faulty. So this is the concept of doing a health check on the servers. Here is an example of how this process works. So we have this virtual server here, which has been configured on the firewall. This is a virtual server, and it has got an IP address of 1.1.1.10. So all the users or the clients, they are sending traffic to the IP address of 1.1.1.10 with the port number of 8080. Whenever this request comes to the firewall, now the firewall knows that this IP address and this port number does not exist on any physical server, so this address has to be translated or converted into the IP address of one of these two servers, which are the real servers that are going to actually receive the traffic. So for example, here it converts this IP address into the IP address of this real server, which is 192.168.0.1, and the port number is also being translated from 8080 to port 80. Most probably this is obviously a web server. So the firewall sends the traffic to this server now. This server responds to the traffic and sends the reply with its own IP address. This IP address is once again converted on the firewall before forwarding the response to the client. So the client once again thinks that the traffic is coming from the server at IP address 1.1.1.10 and the port number 8080, which is the IP address of the virtual server. So this way the client is assuming that it is communicating with a server with this IP address, whereas actually the clients are communicating either with this server or with this server, because these are the real servers which are working in the form of a real server cluster or a real server pool. In an enterprise environment, what happens is that different types of services or different types of applications are running in the data center or in the enterprise environment. And because there is a lot of load on these servers, so we create clusters of these servers. For example, we can have multiple email servers sharing load across them, or web servers or FTP server or database servers, or if it's a tiered application architecture, there could be an app tier. So whenever users send traffic to accessing any of these services, for example email, we have multiple servers. The traffic is going to come in either from the intranet or from the enterprise network within the same branch office or the campus network. When it reaches the firewall is going to distribute the traffic to one of these real servers which are being represented by a virtual server. So this is how an enterprise environment would work, or servers in an enterprise environment would be doing load balancing, and the firewall is responsible for distributing the load across these servers based on a load balancing algorithm, or SLB, server load balancing algorithm. If you look at the different implementation mechanisms, that is the load balancing algorithms, we'll see how we can distribute the load across the physical servers. So load balancing algorithms are the core of SLB, that these load balancing algorithms are the heart and soul of this entire process. So they are used to determine the real server to process the service traffic. The firewall supports the following load balancing algorithms. There are three main algorithms which the firewall can support, which include the round robin algorithm, least connection algorithm, and the sticky session algorithm. What happens with round robin algorithm is that whenever a request comes for one of these, for the server which is representing these four real servers, the firewall is going to forward the traffic first to this server, the next request is going to be forwarded to this server, then to this, and then to this. So one request or one client request is forwarded to each server in a round robin fashion. Once the request has been forwarded to server number 4, the next request will once again be forwarded to server number 1, and so on and so forth. This means that we are using a round robin load balancing algorithm where each request is forwarded to a new server, and once this request has been forwarded to the last server, then the first server is used for sending the request. This is the concept of round robin load balancing algorithm. Least connection algorithm is used when we do not want to overload a server because of the connections, because in case of round robin, the number of connections that are being handled by each server might be different. So we want to distribute the traffic based on the number of connections on each server. So the firewall is going to check, and firewall is going to see that how many connections each server is handling at this particular point in time. And whichever server has got the least number of connections, the firewall will forward the next request to that particular server, which means that this server has got the least amount of load. So the next request will be forwarded to it, and the connection count on this server will increase. And so that all the servers have almost the same number of connections on each one of them at any given point in time. The last one is the sticky session algorithm. This means that the server by default uses a source IP based hash calculation to determine the server which should be used for servicing the requests of that particular client. So what this means is that whenever that client sends another request, that request will be forwarded to the same server again and again. This means that this client is being serviced by the same server. So this is an example of a sticky session load balancing algorithm, where one client or one source IP, request from one source IP, will always be served by the same server. This might be important in situations where we want all the connections from one client to be handled by the same server. That might be the case if the server is authenticating the client, and any change or the other server might have to re-authenticate the client. In that particular case, we might want to use the same server for handling requests from a particular client. So this is the example of sticky session algorithm. In addition to these three basic algorithms, round robin algorithm, least connection algorithm, and sticky session algorithm, we can also have the weighted version of each of these algorithms. We can have a weighted round robin algorithm, we can have a weighted least connection algorithm, and we can have a weighted sticky session algorithm. What this means is that we assign a weight to each of these DL servers. While we are doing the configuration, we assign a weight to each of these DL servers. So whenever a request comes to the firewall not only looks at, for example, in case of round robin, not only looks at where the last connection was sent, but also looks at the weight of each server. This means that if this server has a weight of 2, let's say, the firewall is going to send 2 connections to this server before it sends 1 connection to the next server. If its weight is 1, then the next connection would be sent to this server, and if its weight is also 1, the next connection would be sent to this server. So in this case, if these 4 servers have a weight of 2, 1, 1, and 1, then the firewall is going to forward 2 connections to this server, 1 connection to each of these servers. This is called weighted round robin. Similarly, if we have weighted least connection algorithm, the firewall is going to forward double the number of connections to the server which has got higher weight than the servers which have got half the weight of that particular server. But this is based on the number of connections. And finally, the sticky session, weighted sticky session, also means that the number of connections being sent from any source to any server will depend upon the weight of the server. The server which has got a higher weight, which has got more weight, is going to be forwarded more connection requests as compared to the servers which have got a lower weight value. So we've got 3 basic load balancing algorithms: round robin, least connection, and sticky session. And we've also got the weighted versions of them: weighted round robin, weighted least connection, and weighted sticky session. Now, which particular algorithm we select depends upon the particular requirements that we have. For example, if we've got servers with different capacities or servers that have got different specs, the servers with higher specs should be assigned higher weight values because they can handle more requests and they can handle more connections or they can handle more traffic as compared to servers which have got lower specs. Similarly, depending upon the service type that we are using, we might want to use the sticky session algorithm where we want to make sure that one server gets connection requests from a particular client or all the requests coming from one client should go to the same server. So depending upon the types of servers and their respective performance and the service types that those servers are serving, we might want to use one load balancing algorithm or we might prefer one load balancing algorithm over the others. Then another very important feature that we can use and we should use is the server health check. What server health check means is that under normal circumstances, if a firewall is sending user requests or sending connection requests from the users to the servers without any feedback about the condition of the servers or without any knowledge about the situation or the condition of the servers, there might be a situation that a server has gone down, but the firewall is still forwarding connections to that particular server, which means that those connections will never be served. In this situation, what we can do is that we can enable the server health check. What the health check would do is that the health check is going to constantly update the firewall about the health of the server. So if a server goes down, so if there is any change in the status of the server, we need to know that the server's healthy status has changed, the server is no more available, then the firewall should be able to verify that the server has actually gone down, and then if the server, and therefore it should be able to stop the request sending the request to the server, and finally if the server comes back again, the firewall should be able to know that the server is available once again, and it can start sending requests to the server once again. In order to do this, we can enable the service health check or server health check feature on the firewall, and the firewall is going to check against these protocols, TCP, ICMP, HTTP, DNS, and RADIUS. It's going to send probe packets for these protocols to the different servers in the cluster, and as long as the response is coming from the servers, it will know and it will understand that the server, all the servers are alive and up. But if one of the servers stop sending the response, then the firewall will know that the server is down. It will keep sending the probe packets to the server, and if still the response doesn't come, it will stop sending traffic to that server. However, later on, if that server comes back again, it will start sending traffic to that server once again. So the firewall has to make sure to detect that a server has gone down, to verify that the server has actually or really gone down, and then if the server comes back again, it should be able to take a decision appropriately and start sending the traffic back to the server. So these were the basic concepts of server load balancing and health check, service health check. In the next video, we are going to look at the basic configuration that is involved in server load balancing. So see you in the next video.